if there's people out there watching perhaps now, and the two live options on the table are atheism and Christian theism. And they might want to say, well, maybe agnosticism is just the most respectable decision because at the end of the day, I'm not 100% sure, so I'm just going to remain on the fence. What would you say to someone like
that? Well, I think when you're down to atheism versus Christian theism as your alternatives, mm-hmm. then Pascal's wager really goes through. And that wager is that if you believe and you're right, you gain infinity. Whereas if you believe and you're wrong, you've just lost.
You'll never know.
Either. Well, you'll never know, and all you've lost is the pleasures of sin in this lifetime. Whereas on the atheistic view, if you're wrong, you suffer infinite loss, separation from God. Whereas if you're right as an atheist, all you've gained is the pleasures of sin for this brief lifetime. And so Pascal is quite right in saying, if you do a cost-benefit analysis, if the evidence is equal now, that's the key here, that the evidence can't incline either way. If the evidence is 50-50, then he says a cost-benefit of analysis says you should believe. And I think that's right.
Well, suppose somebody hears that and they agree with you, but they just don't know how to make themselves believe. It feels like they're being hypocrites or something.
Yes.
Or fake, phonies.
Pascal addresses that issue, and he says what you should begin to do is immerse yourself in the Christian community. Start going to church, participating in the services, prayer. I would add things like Bible reading, mm-hmm. Christian fellowship, and God will work a change in your heart through these spiritual practices that can help to bring you to belief.
Mm-hmm.